That's
saying trash the room, okay?
Look at the
Show us around the room. Show us what we've got in the room. We haven't seen the room. What else has he got?
What else have we got? We've got TV, Xbox, wardrobe, baseball bat.
What was that?
Wheelie bin!
Smash his telly! Smash it, hang on, hang on, can we smash his telly? I don't know if we can smash his telly. Do we want to smash his telly? They want you to smash the telly, Dave.
There's a good thing, I brought these.
Dave had with him, yeah, we thought you might say something like this. Dave does have with him some goggles and gloves in case this became destructive, as we thought it may do.
Then, I think we should do this. Can I get a countdown? Can I get a countdown?
Word from the police. We are told our fake policemen are getting close to dropping Chris off near his flat. So it's time to announce the results of our latest vote. Remember, it was a choice between Chris coming home and winning a £10,000 cash prize, which you have, Dave. Do you have the money? Do you have the £10,000?
Yes.
Dave, show us the money. Quick. That's it. That's the prize. Or being kidnapped by a vanload of thugs. Well, you have the votes. The votes have been counted. And you, the majority, have voted for the kidnap. So let's make it happen. Let's make it happen. Right, so you are on, kidnappers. You need to go in and kidnap Chris when he gets out of the police van. So this is not far from Chris's house. They are very close. I'm being told they're very, very close. I'm being told about 10 seconds away. This is live now, as you're watching at home. Here they come, here they come. We have a disused warehouse at the ready. It has not been his night. It's about to get worse. Oh. So they've let him off with a caution. We had some people call the police and say that they got an emergency call out. So they've let him off. Here come the kidnappers. Hang on a second. Hang on, can we hold it? Can we lose? Oh, sorry. I can't hear, there's too many of you talking. Okay, so this show that you've seen is part of 4 1-hours called The Experiment. And tonight's experiment is about something called de-individuation, which is what happens when people become anonymous and the sort of behaviour that it brings out. Now, people watching this at home will have heard me say that everything that we're going to see in the next 50 minutes was unfaked. That was true. But that 50 minutes was up 3 minutes ago, which was when we cut to the kidnap scene. And from that moment, we're actually playing pre-recorded footage, so Chris didn't get run over. It was our stuntman, Will. And we treated this film to make it look like it was happening this evening, even though it was actually shot during the daytime. And we already brought two identical shirts, one for our stuntman and one which we got Chris's girlfriend to give to Chris and make sure that he wore it tonight.
Okay, cut.
Back. So our stuntman was unharmed and Chris, of course, is absolutely fine. And what actually happened to him earlier on was that he was dropped back at his flat, where he found a brand new replacement TV waiting for him and a letter from me explaining what's been happening to him tonight. You, the audience, have been the real subjects of tonight's show. We gave you the masks so you could feel anonymous and just a part of a crowd. And as the evening progressed, you became less and less like individuals and more like a mob. You were affecting a real person, even to the point where you were happy for him to think he'd lost his job and were cheering for his property to be destroyed. You all genuinely voted each time. The majority gave us the negative decision each time. We always had a positive decision there, and the positive decision was always ready to run, but you genuinely each time voted for those situations to get worse and worse, which is something we all do. It's something we're all capable of. We've all been guilty of this mob mentality at some point in our lives. And this experiment has been to show how easily it can happen. Thank you, and good night.
Wow. Comedy coming next. Life was sort of manageable till a down-in-the-dumps Frank turned up. It's Pete versus his ever more complicated life. Next on 4.